Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this tutorial, I will show you how to wrap a texture around 3D text using Photoshop 3D. This technique works best with seamless textures and blocky text. This method is far from perfect and will not be as good as using a 3D modeling program to generate the texture map. But you might get acceptable results depending on your needs. I've tested this with different fonts, different sizes, and various textures, including wood, rock, buildings, and others. This process also works with simple shapes, such as those in your custom shapes presets. Liken this to taking a jigsaw and cutting out letters or shapes from a flat wood board, then wrapping a texture around the letters. To begin, open up a new canvas, 1280 pixels by 720 pixels at 300 pixels per inch. Press D for the default foreground and background colors. Fill the background with 50% gray so that most objects will show up regardless of color. Choose Edit, Fill. Then in the Contents drop-down, choose 50% gray. Open the Type tool. I used Hobo Standard Medium at 72 points. Place the cursor on the canvas, then type in your text. I used the word iced. Press the big check mark to accept. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit the canvas to the screen. To center the text, press Ctrl or Command plus A to select everything. Now press V to choose the Move tool. Click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Press Ctrl or Command plus D to deselect. Ctrl-click the Ice Text layer. From the 3D menu, choose New Extrusion from Current Selection. Answer Yes if asked to switch to the 3D workspace. The Ice 3D object should be selected in the 3D panel. There should be a Properties panel open. If not, you can double-click the star icon next to the ice object, or choose Windows, Properties. Drag the Properties panel and the 3D panel to a convenient location. Shorten the panels to save space. Select Current View, which is probably set to default. Then select the Orbit tool and tilt the letters so you can see their front and their top. Select the iced object. In the Properties panel, change texture mapping to tile. Use the extrusion depth slider to adjust the extrusion depth to your liking. I used 88.37 pixels for this project. Next, we will make some adjustments to demonstrate inflating the fronts of the letters and adding a bevel. Click the Cap option icon in the Properties panel. To inflate the front of the letters, drag the Strength slider to the right. I used 11%. To add a bevel, drag the Bevel Width slider to the right. I used 12%. Next, we will access Photoshop's measurement tools to find the total perimeter around the edges of the letters. Select Current View and change the view to Front. First, press Ctrl or Command click the Ice Layer icon to select it. Choose Image Analysis. Select Data Points. Custom. Now choose Deselect All. Now choose Perimeter, Height, and Width. Next choose Save Preset. Name the preset. I name mine Perimeter. Choose OK to accept the new preset. Go back to Images Analysis. The data points will now default to perimeter. Now choose Record Measurements. The measurement data will appear in the measurements log. For the word iced, 5 rows of information will appear. The top row represents the overall total of all 4 letters. Rows 2, 3, 4, and 5 are the measurements for the letters I, C, E, and D, respectively. We want the perimeter value, width, and height of the top row, which is the total of all 4 letters. In this case, the perimeter is 3640.88, width is 648, and height is 260. Jot down these values on a piece of paper. Now, to clear the measurement log, click the trash can icon and answer yes to delete the measurements. Deselect. Next, if your letters have any holes in them, like the letter O or D, choose the magic wand tool and select all holes in the word. If there is more than one, hold down the shift while selecting additional holes. Click the Record Measurements button. Write down the hole's perimeter value. Click the trash can icon to remove the measurements. Answer yes, you are sure. Close the measurement panel. Close the tab group. Deselect. Choose the Move tool to enter the 3D space. Use the Orbit tool to tilt the letters so we can see the front and the top. Next, we will assign the checkerboard tiling material to all the materials in case we need them later. Select the front inflation material, then hold down the Shift key and select the back inflation material. Now all the materials are selected. Then in the Materials Property panel, click the Texture Material drop-down and choose Tiles Checkerboard Material. For this tutorial, I showed the width as 648 and the height as 260. Your settings will be different depending on the text style and size you used. Grab a calculator, divide the height value by the width value. In this case, I divided 260 by 648 to get a value of 0.4013, or 40.1% rounded. Choose the ice front inflation material. Click the Diffuse folder icon and choose Edit UV Properties. Make the UX scale 40.1%, the value we just calculated. The VY scale should be 100%. Click OK to accept. Repeat the same settings, 40% UV and 100% VY, for the front bevel. Back bevel, and back inflation materials. As you can see, the texture applied to the top and sides of each letter is stretched or banded in some areas. We want squares that are square and approximately the same size as the checker boxes on the front material we did earlier. Here is how to fix it. First, choose the current view from the 3D menu. Change the current view to top. Then move to the ice extrusion material. Choose the folder icon next to the diffuse option and choose Edit UV Properties. Work with the UX scale first. We can approximate the setting by dividing the height by the total of the letter's perimeter and the hole's perimeter. These are the perimeter values we jotted down earlier, which were 3640.88 plus 448.44, totaling 4089.32. So take the height value, which is 648, and divide by 4089.32. That equals 6.4%. And enter that in the Diffuse Material UX setting. That setting basically adjusts the width of the squares on the extrusion material to the same width as the squares on the front inflation material. Click OK to save the settings before making changes to the VY. If you don't, the settings get messed up. Open back up the UV settings. Drag the slider until the squares look square, not rectangular. Drag to the left to make the squares shorter or to the right to make them taller. I used a setting of 26.8%. Go back to current view and choose default view. Then use your orbit tool to inspect and make sure everything looks okay. The extrusion area should all look checkerboardy. Here are some formulas for the UX and VY settings of both the front and extrusion materials. They are also provided on my website. A link is in the description area. Now we want to apply a seamless 2D texture to the entire text object. The seamless texture should be square. Would be best to have a side length that is a power of 2, such as 512 or 1024. Choose the iced 3D object. Choose the iced front inflation material in the 3D panel. Hold down Shift while selecting the back inflation material. Now all materials are selected. In the Material Properties panel, click on the folder next to the Diffuse option. Then choose Replace Texture. The open dialog appears. Browse to where the original ICE 2D texture is on your computer and choose it. Note, when the texture is replaced, the UV settings stay the same. If you added a new texture, the UV settings would be lost. Notice that your texture is now evenly applied to all sides of the letters. Choose the current view. Use the orbit tool to tilt the text where you want it. If you wish, you can still change shine, refraction, etc., as well as diffuse, specular, illumination, or ambient color, or lighting and shadows, before you render the text. Now we'll make some final adjustments to the iced word. Select all the materials by choosing the front inflation material, then holding down Shift, and selecting the back inflation material. Now in the Materials Properties panel, change the opacity to 72%, as ICE is somewhat transparent. Choose the Diffuse color and change the RGB to 1891 and 147 for more of a blue cast. Choose the ICE 3D object. Then choose Infinite Light and adjust the light to your liking. Change infinite light intensity to 92%. Choose the iced 3D object again. In the Layers panel, turn off the background layer. Click the Render button to render the image. When done, duplicate the 3D layer. Rename it Iced 2D. Then right-click the iced 2D layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now save the file and you'll have both the 3D and the 2D versions saved. This completes the tutorial. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. More 3D tutorials are coming. Please subscribe to stay informed.